Hi guys, it's Abby and Elise again doing a rainbow loom tutorial the regular way. Today we are going to only use one loom and needle and as many colors. It does take about 20 rubber bands, somewhat. You want to have the arrow facing you. And today I'm going to be doing two colors because it's kind of easier for the beginners. I'm going to be doing pink and white. Okay. And all the supplies we got at is Michael's.
Yeah, all of it.
Sometimes you can get it at the rubber bands at Big Lots, but they don't work as good. Okay, so first you're going to want to start this peg.
Yes.
And... well, I start at this way.
Okay.
And then you're going to want to do the C to there. And then you're going to take your other color and do it where it ended at and put it like that.
Diagonally.
Okay, diagonally. And do it like that. And then do it again over here. And then do it again over here. And then just keep on doing it up, all the way up.
And you go all the way down the loom.
There is a thing that you want it to all the arrows to be facing.
And if you do have a larger wrist, there is a thing where you can do a extension, but you don't want to.
Yeah. It does take a lot more rubber bands. You can also make the normal one in a necklace form, but that would take like three if you want it long, tight, or short, any way you want. And I am gonna stop right here. Okay, so that's how it's gonna look. And then
there. Then you're going to get your needle,
which is this, and how the arrow is facing towards you this way, it's going to be, you're going to flip it right here, and then Elise is going to be looming for me because I actually did
broke her finger. So I'm going to get my needle. And since my pink is over here, I'm going to start with my white. A bee just flew, a fly just flew near my mouth. I'm going to take my white and put it over the one diagonally to it. Now I'm going to get down there and grab my pink and put it diagonally. My white.
And she is going to be going a little faster because we do have plans today.
Pink. White.
And if it does break, she's going to show you how to do it. She's going to fake have one pop off.
Okay, so one popped off.
Take it all the way.
One popped off.
And it will be that way.
So it popped off from my loom.
So there is a missing space.
I'm going to push down my pink from diagonally to it. I'm going to put my white like I was starting from the beginning. Now carefully, I'm going to take that pink and put that white quickly diagonally from it. Take my pink again and put it where it happened again. And then start back looming and pretend like nothing happened.
And sometimes if you do go a little fast,
you will
end up popping one off. And you are gonna wanna use your hands through and stuff.
But you can use your needle like this. It's just, I do not like using that.
We do have the book manual. It's called Rainbow Loom Jewelry Made Easy.
And that's where we learned ours from.
and some from the internet because they only have a couple in here. They have the single and all these. We will be showing all these on ours except the Dumbo Rumbus, the Diamond, and the Butterfly
Blossom, and the Double X. Okay. So I've gone all the way down my loom, and there should be, it's kind of like a triangle, but not really. Now I'm going to take a C-clip. Does look like that.
Oh, and we do have a complaint about people using the S ones, which do look like that, but they actually work a little bit better.
So I'm gonna take my C-clip, I'm gonna take where the hole is and put it through the pink. And it should pop right on. And pick it up. I'm just gonna pull it off.
Not so fast though, because it can break.
Now I'm gonna put my finger at the last peg where my rubber band is.
Sorry, there is dirt. We are outside.
And she has a little brother. Then I'm going to take and spread my pink apart. Put my C-clip through it. And voila, you have a single bracelet. Hope you enjoyed. Bye.